and nice for Will Eisenberg, everybody.
How's it going, guys? Welcome to the second half. Yeah. Hey, give it up for your servers and manager. Give it up. Yeah, yeah. They do work. Do a lot of hard work serving you guys drinks. Nice. Bit about me. I'm a single guy. I'm single by choice. Not my choice. Everyone else's choice. But I was on Tinder recently. Anyone else depressed? Anyone? This one girl. On her profile, she said that she wanted to be treated like a princess. So I said, all right, give her a poisoned apple, nice. It could have been worse. I could have, you know, kidnapped her, given her family smallpox, singing about the colors of the wind, you know. That was dark. Oof. Anyways, so I finally met this really great girl. She was perfect, except she had standards. And I've never met standards. Ever, yeah, because what I look for in a girl is two basic things. I want her to accept me for all my flaws and imperfections, and she has to be perfect. That's what I want. So we're hanging out, and she tells me that I look like I should be an actor in movies, but as an extra. And I said, yeah, I do have a very non-distracting face. Whenever I walk into a club, all the ladies are like, oh, hello there, background. And then she says that I looked really handsome in sunglasses. I'm like, yeah, I do look good with a third of my face covered. Yeah. I look really sexy if I was wearing, like, a welding mask or something. Yeah. I know what I look like. I'm not gorgeous. I'm not hideous. Like, I have a six-pack, depending on the lighting. And it sort of starts out well-defined, but as it goes down, it's like I'm running out of toner. Like, I'm running out of toner while I'm toning my abs, or I don't know. Yeah, but it's important to be self-aware, you know? Like, my high school friend, she recently posted, like, guns don't kill people, dads with pretty daughters do. It's you! No. And I was like, your dad's not going to kill anyone, sweetie. No. No. Anyways, so I'm taking this girl out. We saw a nice romantic comedy. It was about the clown that lures children to their deaths. And I'm not talking about Ronald McDonald, although he does do that. It was Stephen King's monster that assumes, you know, the shape of your worst fear. But I don't think that would be much of a threat to me. Like, what, I'm going to be dragged into the sewer by responsibilities? And strangled by commitment? I am scared of a lot of things, though, like climate change. I would do anything to stop climate change except for change any of my habits. I don't know. Yeah. Like, oh, the ozone. What are we going to do? You have to drive your car a little less. I'll pass. Yeah, but no, like, I do want to, you know, I want to fix issues. Like, if I'd been back there in, you know, the 1860s with slavery, I would not have stood by and watched it. I would have done the socially responsible thing. I would have called it out on Twitter, guys. Yeah, that's who I fix problems. And then BuzzFeed would run articles, this guy had the most perfect response to slavery. And people would retweet me. They'd retweet me with those hand clap emojis. This is how you fight systemic oppression. Except that some people would get offended because the hand clap emojis aren't racially diverse, and then they make them racially diverse. But then people would get offended, like, you know, that the black hand emojis are bigger than the yellow hand emojis. Because we all know that Twitter is just a contest to see who can be the most offended, right? The point is, people, hand emojis do not solve social problems. Pretty girls who tweet do. That's it for me, guys. Hey, give a big warm welcome to the first comic of the second half. Colin Hartwig!